Father, we thank you. We exalt you. We bless your holy name. We magnify your name, O Lord, because you are God and forever be God. Father, accept our thanks in Jesus' name. My Father, my God, we commit this platform into your hands, O God. Holy Ghost, come and take total control in Jesus' name. We come against every disruption. We come against every distraction. We come against every plan and mighty things through this platform in the name of Jesus. Set the captives free and put the devil to shame in the name of Jesus. You are the light that shineth and darkness cannot comprehend. Father, this hour, overshadow this platform. Let your light overshadow every soul that will be connecting right now in the name of Jesus. Let your light overshadow me as well in the name of Jesus. And Lord, let every form of darkness, oh God, be disgraced right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying. Say, oh Lord, my Father, by your power, disgrace every power that wants to disgrace me. Oh Lord God, my Father, by your power, disgrace any power that wants to disgrace me. Oh Lord God, my Father, disgrace any power that wants to disgrace me. Oh Lord, disgrace them. Oh Lord, disgrace any power from the pit of hell that wants to disgrace me. Oh Lord, disgrace them. Oh Lord, disgrace them. Oh Lord, disgrace them. Open your mouth and pray. Let God disgrace. Jesus' name, we have prayed. Say, powers of darkness. Powers of darkness speaking woe into my destiny. I command you to die. Any power speaking woe, speaking defeat into my life, into my destiny. I command you to die. I command you to die. Wicked power speaking woe, speaking defeat, speaking failure into my life. I command you to die. Open your mouth and command them to die. Powers of darkness speaking woe, speaking defeat, speaking failure into my life, into my home. I command you to die in Jesus' name. We have prayed. Say, wicked altars erected to take my blood. Wicked altars erected to drink my blood. You are a liar. Scatter by fire. Scatter, scatter, scatter. Every wicked altars erected to drink my blood, to drink the blood of my children, I command you to scatter. I command you to scatter. I command you to scatter. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Beloved, today is the day to pray for the nation. Where you are staying, that land must bear fruit for you. You will pray like this. Say, you, the land of Ireland, hear the voice of the Lord. Cooperate with my life. You, the land of Ireland, you pray for the land where you are living. Say, you, the land of Ireland, hear the voice of the living God. Cooperate with my life. Cooperate, 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 cooperate with my life. In the name of Jesus, you, the land of Ireland, hear the voice of the living God. I command you right now, cooperate with my life. Cooperate with my life. Cooperate with my life. Cooperate with my life. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Say, strong man in charge of this land. I am in charge now. Die, strong man in charge of Ireland. I am now in charge. Die, die, die. Command the strong man to die. Every strong man or strong woman, controlling the land where you are living, tell them you are now in charge. Command them to die. Command them to die. Command them to die. Command them to die. I command them to die. I command them to die. I command them to die. In Jesus' name, it is done. Say, untimely death. In the land of Ireland, pack your load and disappear. Untimely death. In the land of Ireland, pack your load, disappear. 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 In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You will pray again for the land where you are staying. Beloved, that land is flowing for milk and honey. God planted you there for you to flourish, for you to enjoy, for you to have good life. You will pray like, say, any power that wants me to suffer in Ireland. Ah, there are some powers. They want you to live in a land flowing for milk and honey and for you to have your home without milk and honey. You will pray. Say, powers that want me to suffer in the land of Ireland. You are a liar. Da, da, da. Any power that wants me to suffer in the land of Ireland. You are a liar. Da, da. Open your mouth and pray. Pray for your land. Any power that wants you to suffer, that wants your children to suffer, that wants your marriage to suffer in the land of Ireland, command them to die. Da, 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 da. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Pray this last one. While we're praying, the Lord just dropped that one in my spirit, man. Say, King to the gate of Ireland, I possess you by fire. I would say, lift up your head, so you gate. If the gate of a country is not lifted up, there is no way you two can enter. You can be there physically, but spiritually, you may be locked out of a country. You will cry like this. Say, key to the gate of Ireland. I am available. I possess you by fire. Key to the gate of wealth. Key to the gate of glory. Key to the gate of riches in the land of Ireland. I am available. I possess you. I possess you. I possess you. I possess you. My children possess you. My family possess you. My marriage possess you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Father, we thank you again. We bless you because you are still God and forever be God. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. Lord, we commit this platform into your hand this morning. Father, let your fire fall upon us today in the name of Jesus. Let there be uncommon encounter today in the name of Jesus. Let there be the move of power of God upon every soul here today in the name of Jesus. By the authority in the name of our Lord Jesus, I decree that any problems in your life, any situation that is making you to cry, any situation that is about to make you to shed tears, I bury them now in the name of Jesus. Let them be buried. They are buried. They are buried. They are buried in the name of Jesus. Your life will not suffer. Your life will not wear out in the name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. Lord, I release myself before you. Anything inside of me, O Lord, that will open the door of my life to the enemies. Father, let those things, O God, be pushed out right now by your fire in the name of Jesus. I surrender all to you, Lord. Father, break me down. Remote me and speak your word through me. Do not let me speak of myself, but let the Holy Spirit of God speak his word through me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen, amen, amen. In Jesus' name. Beloved, I would like to say a very big thank you to you all for joining us today. Today is your day. It's your day that the Lord God Almighty will give you another level. A level whereby the enemies will look at you and they will not be able to touch you. A level whereby you will be mounting up with wings like the eagle. And the enemies will be a serpent and your eagle will be tearing the enemies apart. By the reason in the word of God today, your life will be empowered. In Jesus' name, it is settled. Amen. Sorry about the break in transmission. I know there are times when some things happen that are beyond your control. But thank God that we are back. The devil is a liar. God will still do what he has promised to do. Very briefly, we are looking at what is titled, If Thou Shall Forget the Lord Thy God to Walk After Other Gods. If you and I shall forget the Lord our God and walk after other gods, there are consequences for that action. Remember, look at your life from the beginning. The Lord has been there. Look at your home. The Lord has been there. Look at your job. The Lord has been there. Look at everything around you. The Lord has been there. During the time of Corona, many people died. The Lord has been there for you. During the time of Corona, many people are in the hospital. The Lord has been there for you. Are you appreciating this God? Or you are ascribing the glory to your homemaking? Let's read Deuteronomy chapter 8. We're supposed to read from verse 1 to 20, but because of our time, let's read quickly from verse 10. From verse 10 to 20. In verse 10, the Bible says, when thou hast eaten and art full, then thou shalt bless the Lord thy God. When you are settled, when everything is working fine for you, the Bible says, you must bless the Lord thy God. For the good land which he has given you, you must appreciate God always for the good life, for the good land he has brought you to establish you. Hear what the Bible says. Beware that thou forgettest not the Lord. Beware that you don't forget God. Beware that you don't forget God in not keeping his commandment and his judgment and his statutes, which I command thee this day. Lest when thou hast eaten and art full and hast built godly houses and dwelled therein, and when thy herd and thy flocks multiply, and thy silver and thy gold is multiplied, and all that thou hast is multiplied, then thy heart be lifted up, and thou forget the Lord thy God. Mark those things that we have just read. When everything is now working fine for you, you have your good children, you have your cars, you have your houses, you have good life, Bible says, then your heart will now be lifted up. Then you now start looking as if maybe you are the one that achieved all those things by yourself. That is what many of us are now. When we were nothing, when we were nobody, we were serving God, we were humble in the presence of God. But now that the Lord has blessed us, now we are now lifted, we are now lifting our souls up above God. Hear what the Bible says. Then thy heart be lifted up, and thou forget the Lord thy God, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage, who led thee through that great and terrible wilderness, wherein were fiery serpents and scorpions and drought, where there was no water, who brought thee forth water out of the rock of flint, who fed thee in the wilderness with manna, where thy fathers knew not, that he might humble thee, and that he might prove thee to do this good in thy latter end. And thou say in thy heart, my power and my might of my hand have gotten me this wealth. When everything is now fine, don't say that, in fact, it's the work of my hand. It's my qualification. It's my connection. No. Hear what verse 18 says. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God. In all the things he has done for you, thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he, it is God that has given you the power to achieve all these things. Not your friends, not your connection. It is God who has given you the power to achieve all this. The Bible says, remember the Lord thy God. Give him the power to achieve that he may establish his covenant which is sworn unto thy fathers, as it is this day. Hear what verse 19 says. That's where the topic, that's where God brought out the topic for me today. Say, my son, that is what I want you, I want to use you to speak through. Verse 19. And it shall be, if thou do at all, if we do at all, forget the Lord our God, and walk after other gods, and serve them, and worship them, I testify against you this day that ye shall surely perish. As the nations which the Lord destroyed before your face, so shall ye perish, because ye will not be obedient unto the voice of the Lord your God. God says, whosoever will not honor him, whosoever will not appreciate him, whosoever will forget him, God says, that person will perish. Now you can see the reason why so many Christians, so-called Christians, are dying like chickens, are perishing. When they were nobody, they would be humble in the house of God. As soon as they have small wealth, the church becomes their place of fight. They turn their back against God, thinking money can save them. No, money cannot save you. Thinking it is their connection. In fact, in my few years in the ministry, at times I cry for people when I look at the way they behave. Some, they even talk as if maybe they own the heaven and the earth. Some, for them, when you correct them, they take offense. And I looked at them, where is their life today? Where is their life heading to? They are heading towards destruction. If you will not honor the Lord thy God, Bible says, if thou shalt forget the Lord thy God and walk after other gods, say, thou shalt surely perish. Many people are perishing. And start asking yourself, why are these things happening? Go and check their lives very well. They have turned their back against their maker. And there is no way you can turn your back against your maker and still enjoy the protection of your maker. Many people are now like the prodigal son. The prodigal son turned his back against his father. And what happened? He cut himself off from divine source. I pray for you this hour, that any power anywhere that wants you to turn your back against God, such powers are buried now. They are buried now. They are buried now. In the name of Jesus, anything inside of you that will make you to lift up your heart above God, that thing is destroyed now. It's destroyed now. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, it is done. Quickly, what are those things that can make a man to forget God? Beloved, let's be practical with ourselves. What are those things that you and I are doing that are making us to forget God? Number one is promotion. When a man is down on the floor, the man will be humble. Let the man start having a bit of promotion. Then the man will start, in fact, you start seeing excuses upon excuses. Why the man cannot attend service, why the man cannot pray, why the man is, and many of us, little promotion has made many to forget the Lord. And when there is problem, they come. Pastor, pray. Who am I to pray? Pray for what? I can pray, but who answers the prayer? It is God. Don't wait for someone to pray for you. Go to your Father. If your ways are right with God, go and knock at the door. Let's make our ways to right with God so that when we knock at the door, God will answer us. Number two is position of power. When people start having a bit of power, they forget the church and they forget God. We are looking at what are those things that can make a man to forget God. Number three is money and riches. Money and riches. Take money from the pocket of a man, you see a very humble man. But put money in the pocket of a man, you see a man's true character. Have you ever seen even men of God? Apostle 1, Apostle 2, Apostle 3, Apostle 4. They put it on their plate numbers. And by the time they are going, somebody will carry their Bible. But when they were nobody, beloved, when they were poor, did anybody carry their Bible for them? Oh, please, help me out, church. Have you ever read in the Bible where somebody was carrying the Bible for Jesus Christ? Or somebody was carrying something for Jesus? No, Jesus was humble. He demonstrated core humility. Then where did we find our own ways of life now? Praise the Lord. Number three. Number three. No, we are going to number four. Social status and gathering. When we now start forming groups, now start telling ourselves we belong to this elite club. Some people are not in our category. Some are in our category. And by so doing, they start saying, oh, in fact, our social club, they're having, in fact, at times I wonder when a social club will put meetings on a Sunday and you start seeing people, I went for a social club. You are turning your back against God and you are walking towards destruction. In fact, you are going to a social club. I wonder, you are not going to a social club. Are they preaching God there? What are they preaching there? They are serving you alcohol. Ways of destruction. Next is pride. Pride. Next is education. Small education you get swollen headed. You know, don't you know I'm a PhD holder? Don't you know I'm this and that? Don't you know I'm studying for my master's? And so what? Education must not take you away from God. In fact, our assignment is due, so I will not be in church. My assignment is due. I pity your life. If your assignment is due, then your assignment must be, in fact, you must leave God for your assignment. Abandon the church. Abandon the presence of God. Who gave you that life? That admission, who gave it to you? God gave you the admission. Now you are turning your back against God. Next, our career. In fact, I'm chartered. In fact, I'm a doctor. I'm a this and this. And you've abandoned God. You don't come to church again. You start taking job on a Sunday deliberately just to avoid church. I pity your life. I pity such a life. Next is the enemy. When the enemy knows who you are very well, they can come in and take you away from God's presence. The enemy knows who you are. Devil knows you very well. It is you that don't know yourself. It is me, I don't know myself. But devil knows who we are. And when the devil sees that we don't know who we are, he will take us away. Praise the Lord. Next is our family. To some of us, oh, my son, my daughter, they are going for sport on a Sunday. Anytime there is a service, that's why you see some of us. Oh, in fact, I'm taking my son for sport. I'm taking my son for this. You are deserting God. Ooh, God gave you those children. They must not turn their back. You must not use your own hand to turn your children's back against God. So what are those symptoms? When someone is turning against God, what are the signs that we should look out for? Beloved, I want you to be practical with your life. I want my life to be practical from today. That every teaching we are that God is giving us on this platform, don't just take it as, oh, it's Pastor Tokumbo. Take it home and start applying them to your daily life. And it will help us. So what are those signs that we should look for in a life that is forgetting God? Number one, faulting the church service. Anytime you see anybody in the church faulting the service, in fact, the service is too long, the service is too this, not one thing, they have turned their back against God. Anytime you see people that are not turning their back against God. Number two, when you see people that are faulting the pastor that once prayed for them, for miracles to happen, now they're not faulting the pastor. Pastor is so biased. Pastor is this. Pastor, you are faulting the man that God used to pray for you and signs and wonders happened. You are turning your back against God. Some people, when they were nothing, they remained in the church. Now that they have something small, they can no longer fellowship with us again. I don't know the riches you have that is making you to turn your back against God. Solomon was rich, he still served God. David, the man after God's heart, he served God. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, they were wealthy, they served God. Your Sunday job will never make you wealthy because God will blow it away. We'll get there in our teachings. When we give detestable service to God, we just treat God anyhow, and God will throw the same thing back at us. In fact, things are not working for. Why would things work for that person? A person that is treating the maker anyhow, treating the head anyhow. How will things work for the person? Beloved, let's learn from now to work with God and in God. Whatever we own, let's give God all the glory for it. Anytime I look at myself, beloved, I will share my life testimony with you. Anytime I look at myself, I normally say it in my language, say, Anu ni moriba. I know it is by His grace. I looked around me, at times I said, Tokumbo. Hey, I looked at what the Lord has done, and the only answer I have for my life is, Ulu, Anu ni moriba. I'm not looking for billions. But God has given me a comfortable life. That any day I look and say, Anu ni moriba, it is grace. It is by His grace. That's why when you see me every time, say, no, I must preach the gospel because that is the source of my strength. I cannot depart from God. And I'm praying, the Lord, do not let me see what will take me from your presence. Because the moment I say I'm not preaching again, I'm not serving God again, the grace will depart. The grace will depart. Next, signs that someone is turning away from God is attending the church services late. They will come to church late and they will start gossiping and talking in the church, disrupting the service. They have turned their back against God. Go and check such lives. Check what is happening in their lives. You come before king and you are disrupting the presence of the king will curse that person. The same thing with God. God is even, the judgment of God is even stricter than the judgment of man. When God is about to visit a judgment upon a life, nobody can be the judge. Nobody can intervene. When King Saul went to the battle, God told him, kill all this enemy. He went there. He did as he pleased. And God gave it to him back, the way to God pleased. The same God that judged King Saul, that's the same God that we are still serving. Praise the Lord. Next, not obeying the Bible is another sign. I want to beg of you, on no account should you go to church, or on no account should you start your day, or on no account should you live your day without referencing to the Bible. When you reference the Bible, that means you are connecting with God. And when you don't study the Bible, you don't read the Bible, you don't meditate on the Bible, you are turning your back against God. Every day, nobody called you from your work to come and resume. But the pastor must call you to come to church. They must call you to come and pray. No! Don't turn your back against God. Bible says, I tell you, I testify against you that this day, that ye shall surely perish, whosoever shall turn his back against you. The Bible says, that person shall surely perish. So it tells you now that look deep into the world. How many people are perishing? You think maybe somebody will now fall down and die like a cockroach? No. They die slowly. Spiritual death, slowly, 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 slowly. And by the time it gets to a point, then the life will start dying gradually. They start falling sick, having all kinds of infirmities, having all kinds of attack. And before you know it, they say, ah, what a pity. He just died. She just died. Check their lives. May God help us in Jesus' name. Next, they love spiritual materials, but not God. Beloved, I want to beg of you, and I want you to be honest with yourself. If I say by tomorrow, everybody should bring water, salt, and broom, the platform now, even people that you don't even know, you tell them, say, one apostle, he said, you should bring water, broom, this, the platform may be jam-packed. Why? People love things like that, but they don't love God. You have a service in church. Oh, let's do impartation. Or let's do sweeping of the environment from ungodly spirits. You see the church getting full. But when you are telling them, if thou shalt forget the Lord thy God and walk after other gods, God says, I testify before you, and thou shalt surely perish. You start seeing people saying, oh, God. In fact, this pastor now, wow. And does he think he's the only one? No. Beloved, I keep praying this prayer, and I want you to pray it yourself, and let's pray together for ourselves, that God should not allow us to speak with enticing words of man. God should not allow you and I to preach the gospel just to entice people. The gospel is not supposed to be preached to entice anybody. It's supposed to be preached to correct us. It's supposed to be preached to direct our path. It's supposed to be preached to rescue us. It's not supposed to be preached to make us be dancing. The gospel is not a danceable teaching. The soul that snares shall die. That kind of a teaching is not something that you will listen to and you go back home and start saying, oh, I'm going to fornicate. Never. Because when you understand that death is waiting for any sinner, you will flee from every appearances of sin. Beloved, it is time to pray. I don't know the thing in your life or in my life that is making me to feel that, yes, I've arrived. What have you arrived? What have you achieved? Let me ask you, what have you achieved? That is making us to feel like, oh, we're on top of the world. What do you think you have achieved? If God opens your eyes to see what he has for you, the plans ahead of you, you'll be crying for yourself. Say, ah, Father, I've not even achieved anything. Pray like this. Say, Father, I am sorry. Including myself, all of us. Let's say, Father, we are sorry for turning our back against you, for worshiping other gods, for worshiping our job, for worshiping our family, for worshiping our parents. Father, we are sorry. Ask God right now. That is the only prayer. Lord, I am sorry. Father, I am sorry for not serving you well. I am sorry. I am sorry. I am sorry. I am sorry, O Lord. Father, I am sorry. Have mercy. Have mercy. I am sorry, O Lord. Have mercy. I am sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I am sorry, O Lord. Father, have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy. I have come back like the prodigal son. Father, accept me back. Accept me back, O Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. In Exodus chapter 34, verse 14. Exodus chapter 34, verse 14. The Bible says, for thou shalt worship the Lord thy God. Thou shalt worship no other God. You and I must not serve any other God. For the Lord, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. You and I must not worship or serve any other gods. For the Lord our God, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. Exodus 34, verse 14. Our God is a jealous God. So if after the Lord has blessed us with all this massive blessing, if we now turn our back against him, how will you feel, beloved, as individuals? After you have helped someone, you laid your life down for that person, you built the person up from scratch to greatness, and the person now turns his or her back against you and starts slandering you, will you be happy? That is what God is telling you. Say, he's a jealous God. Tell God, say, Lord, I'm sorry. Father, we are sorry, O Lord. Have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy, O Lord. Have mercy. Even nations We have come short of his glory. Ask God to have mercy. Father, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Have mercy, O Lord. Forgive us, O Lord. Forgive us. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Father, we thank you because you have done it again. Father, Lord, we, your children, we are here, O Lord, and we surrender all to you. In any way, whereby we have been using your blessings to support idols. In any way, whereby we have been using your blessings to fight you. In any way, whereby we have been using your blessings to cause division in the body of Christ. Father, have mercy. Forgive us, O Lord. Give us a new heart. A heart to follow you. A heart to obey you. And a heart to do your wish and your will. Thank you, blessed Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen, amen, amen. In Jesus, beloved, remember that you are destined to be great. Whenever you see the light of another beautiful day, remember that it is by his grace that you are alive. The same sleep that you woke up from, some people slept that same sleep yesterday. Now they are no more. They are dead. Some people woke up this morning the same way you woke up. Now, this time, they are gone. So always appreciate God for his grace and the covenant of life. Till we meet tomorrow, if this teaching is a blessing to you, be an evangelist to someone by sharing this. If you want to download it and send it to other people, go to our YouTube page. Our YouTube page is the Reality Christian Center channel, or on our website, www.thepathofrighteousness.com. Please share as many as you can lay your hands upon. Many people are walking on the pathway of destruction, thinking it is their power that has given them the wealth. Many are even cursing the pastors. There are people that are thinking, in fact, that pastor is literally the man that you were calling Father in the Lord before. All of a sudden, you are now insulting him. God is not happy. So please, help people like that who don't know the truth. Share the truth with them and let them be saved. Till you meet tomorrow, same time, 9 a.m. in the morning for the hour of prayer. Tomorrow is our healing and deliverance session. You have to bring your bottle of water. And please, when you are coming tomorrow, come with a very aggressive spiritual man to pray and to break yourself loose from every ancestral chains. And you see God setting you free in the name of Jesus. Let's share the grace and fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. 7 glorious hallelujah. Let's go. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Sons and daughters of the Most High God, you came to this world to shine and to mount up with wings like the eagle. It is your day. A day to be blessed. Go right now and conquer the world and enjoy the fullness of God. Till we meet tomorrow. Bye.